Hello everyone and welcome back to my channel. My name is Steph from Green Grow Love and today I'm taking you along with me on a Saturday adventure slash garden tour, nursery slash community garden slash just a little bit of everything. So my first stop is Diacos Garden Nursery. I just pulled up, car is off, everything is off, but I'm gonna go walk through the nursery, see what they've got. I'm not looking at purchasing anything today, but you never know. I might just see something that I really love or that I really want and I might have to buy it. So we'll go through there and then we'll probably go to my community garden. We're going to pick up some passata from an Italian supermarket close to Diacos Nursery. I don't really vlog in public, but I guess let's go in and let's see. So we're going to Diacos. The nursery's mostly outside. They had really long and spacious aisles with large signs letting you know what section you were in, or if you were looking for a specific plant, it was really easy to find. I've had a quick look on their website and you can actually purchase plants online from Diacos. I believe you can arrange click and collect, or they also have a delivery service that I believe starts from about $35. They had this section under a shade cloth with annual veggies and flowers. There was also a section with indoor plants and accessories near the register. After checking out, I actually realised that I'd bought an indoor plant from Diacos at the International Flower and Garden Show last year. Okay, I'm back in the car. That was such an awesome nursery. So many beautiful plants, so many beautiful shrubs, so many beautiful everything. I ended up with one small, inexpensive little shrub. It's actually a ground cover. It's called Calocephalus, and it's got little white flowers. It runs across the ground. There was a beautiful pink lavender plant in there. It was $30 and I hadn't planned on buying anything, so I didn't get it, but I don't know. I'm already regretting it. I might go back again. I'm not sure. But there were so many beautiful things in there. Yeah, highly recommend, and I'll be back. Next up is Frank's supermarket, where I'm picking up some passata for my mum. Okay, I picked up 2 12-packs of passata for my mum. She also wanted some crostoli, but I think I might have to sneak one in before I drop it off to her. I wonder if she will realise, or if she will only realise once you're watching this video. Hi, mum!
Yes.
I haven't mastered the art of vlogging in public yet, so here we are again, car turned off, chatting to you. What would be a spontaneous garden nursery trip day out vlog without coming to Poyntons here in the Maribyrnong? Again, just like the nursery before, I'm not planning on buying anything, but I guess we'll see what happens. This video is starting to sound like a sales pitch or that it's sponsored, but I promise you it's not. I just love exploring nurseries and I'm so glad that I get to show you them. This nursery here, Poyntons, is located along the Maribyrnong River. They have a really nice cafe where you can have breakfast, lunch and drinks, and they have plenty of levels of plants on this lot. The The further back you go through this nursery, the higher it is on a hill. So if you are wanting to get to the nursery, just keep that in mind. I had a look on their website, and although you can't purchase anything, you can browse through some of the products they sell and find the prices. I am at my community garden. My phone unfortunately died just at the end of Poyntons, so I couldn't show you the little hall, but I'll show you when I get home. And I'm at my community garden now, just like I said, but I probably won't be able to show you much because I think I'm at about 2%. So hopefully I can show you a little bit and I'll chat to you all when I get back home. I didn't realize I planted an iris here. There's an iris, some beautiful flowers, the nasturtium. All of the brassicas have gone to seed. I've got some leeks. The tomatoes are looking good considering I haven't been here in a while and watered them. The zucchini looks good. The pumpkin, not so good, but that's okay. I'll give it a bit of a water today. And some more zucchini out the back here. So I'll give everything a bit of a water. Pretty cool to see the flowers on the chili plant though.
It also looks like a volunteer dahlia has popped up.
Okay, I had such a lovely day at the nurseries and my community garden, picking up the passata for my mum. So I ended up with this one here, the ground cover from Diacos. I ended up with 3 different spring onion heads from my community garden. This pot for an upcoming video that I'm going to be posting about gifts. This was $6 or $9, I'm not sure. Let me show you them. So I ended up picking up this one here. It's the Princess Lavender. It was slightly pinker than the rest of them. I still regret not buying that first one at Diacos, but I probably will go back eventually and get it. But so I got this one here for $17. My husband's been wanting me to plant some kale. So I picked up 2 different kale. I'm not sure if you can see those, but I got a Red Russian and a Richo Blue. And then at Poyntons they have 5, if you buy 5 potted flowers, you get it a little bit cheaper. So this is also for an upcoming video that about gift giving, but I got the white dianthus, I believe it is. I got this beautiful sweet alyssum. I got a marigold. I'm not sure if you can see that. I got this one here. I'm not actually sure of the name of it, but it's super cool. That flower. And then a beautiful like poison berry, raspberry, snapdragon. And at Poyntons I spent just under $50. And then at Diacos Nursery it was $7.95. So overall I had an amazing day and I'm so glad that I got out the camera and could bring you all along with me. So thank you so much. I hope you enjoyed this different type of video, a bit more of a vlog, what I got up to in the day today. If you have any questions, feel free to pop them down in the comments below. And thank you so much for stopping by. I'll see you again in my next video. Bye!